How to create animated double exposure effect in Photoshop. Welcome back to PhotoshopDesire.com YouTube channel. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create animated double exposure effect, created by blending a standard image, typically a person with a video scene. First, open an image into Photoshop. The way the result looks depends mostly on the amount of white areas in the image. The best images to be used contain white or almost white backgrounds. So, if you open an image of a person with a white background, the overlapping video effect will only be visible on the darker areas of the subject and not on the white background. In my case, selected photo has a gray background. So I begin by clipping out the subject from the portrait photograph. Make selection closely follow the outline of the person's profile. Go to Select. Choose Select and Mask. Begin altering the edge detection radius to bring the hairline into the selection. Extending the edge selection will also bring in areas of the background around the face and hair. Select the brush to the Refine Radius tool. And paint around the hairline to capture any stray hairs that aren't yet in the selection. Copy this new selection from the background and paste it onto a new layer. Now copy image and paste it into the working document. Now the person image contains white background. I want the image to look straight, so take a free transform tool, Ctrl plus T, and rotate the image. We need to increase the contrast, so duplicate the person cutout layer, and change blending mode to overlay. The overlay blend mode both multiplies dark areas and screens light areas at the same time, so dark areas become darker and light areas become lighter. Open up the levels adjustment, and begin darkening the image by moving the input and output level sliders. Group the layers. Now place the video footage or image sequences. Go to Layer tab. Select Video Layer. And then select New Video Layer from File. I captured the time-lapse sequence of 3 seconds long. I will use this sequence for animation. You may use any scenes from nature landscapes to cities as you wish. Or if you want to use a photo instead of a video, then paste your own photo. Change the blending mode of this new video layer to screen, to render all the dark areas transparent. Double-click the video layer to open the blending options window. Hold the Alt key and drag the black slider towards right. By doing this, we will partially hide the gray portions and achieve a better blending effect with the person. Normally, double exposure effect looks good in black and white. So let's achieve this effect. Add a black and white adjustment layer to wash out the color of the image. We finished the blending and layer adjustments part. Now turn on the video mode. To view the animation, open the timeline from the window menu. Trim the timeline to 3 seconds long, same as video length. Click the play icon to render files and review. Check loop playback to play forever. If you're interested in colored animation, then disable the black and white layer. We can increase contrast or remove white areas, simply by adding solid color black layer, and change layer blending to soft light. Reduce opacity around 50%. If you want more contrast effect, then keep the solid color layer, or otherwise hide it. When you're happy with the result, export the animation. Go to Timeline menu options and select Render Video. In the Render Video dialog box, enter a name for the video or image sequence. Specify format specific options from the menus below the file format menu and click render. We can also export this animation as GIF, with loop playback for web. If you are saving your animation as a GIF image, optimize it for efficient download to a web browser. when optimizing the colors in an animation. Use the adaptive, perceptual, or selective palette. This ensures that the colors are consistent across frames. Click the Save button and select Folder to tell Photoshop where to save the exported file. We're done. And here is my final result. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel for more interesting tutorials. Post a comment, click thumbs up, like and share to get more videos. See you again in next video tutorial.